Hello friends, Namaskar. Today's topic of our income tax discussion is, can NRI avail the benefit of basic exemption limit or not? See, this question is highly important for NRI SSEs because while they earn income in India and it is taxed, they would be certainly interested in knowing, say for example, 2,50,000 rupees is the basic exemption limit. Further, there is a slab rate benefit which is available to the normal SSEs. Would that particular slab rate benefit, exemption limit benefit will be also available to a NRI or not? So let's see answer to this particular question in today's video. So at first, my dear friends, I am putting up before you the coverage in form of 5 queries which we are going to take up here. What are the prevailing slab rates? Let's know them. Types of income of NRI in India. Whether slab rate benefit is available to a NRI or not. Can new slab rate, which is inserted by Finance Act 2020, that is applicable from financial year 2021, is also available to NRI or not? And whether the benefit of Section 87A rebate is also available to a NRI or not? Let me first put up before you, my dear friends, the slab rates which are available to all the individual SSEs. Whether these slab rates, maybe they are for the assessment year 21-22, 22-23. When I am putting up these slab rates, the question in my mind is whether these slab rates will be available to NRI or not, that we will discuss further. First, I am simply putting up that there is an old regime and there is a new regime. This new regime was inserted by 115 BAC section by last budget, that is budget 2020, last year's budget. Herein it was said that up to 2,50,000 in both the cases nil will be the taxation, up to 2,50,000 above to 5,00,000 5%. Then 5 to 7.5, you find out a difference of 10% between these two. Further, again, you find here 5% difference. Here it is 10% difference, 5% difference, and above 15 lakh, it is same for all. My question is that whether these slab rates could be availed of by a NRI or not. Let's discuss it further. I would like to add here one conceptual point, a very important point, that what are the types of income of NRI in India from the point of view of slab rate applicability. Such an income of NRI, my dear friend, could be bifurcated either into special rate income or could be bifurcated into normal rate income. So you need to see whether the NRI is earning a special rate income in India or normal rate income in India. Now your question to me would be, ke Bhatia ji, what do you want to say from a special rate income? Say for example, as an NRI, you earn short term capital gain, which is subject to STT, which is taxable at the rate 15% in India. Or you might be earning long term capital gain, which is subjected to STT based securities, then that is taxable at the rate 10% in India. So the thumb rule, which we can create here of, if as an NRI, you have a special rate income in India, you forget about basic exemption limit benefit. But if you have normal rate income, say for example, you have salary income in India or you have house property income in India, you have income by way of interest from NRO account, etc. Then in that case, such an income could be subject matter of basic exemption limit. So just to reiterate my point very clearly, whether slab rate benefit is available to a NRI, as I said, that slab rate benefit is not available on following a special rate income earned by a NRI in India. What? Say for example, short-term capital gain, which is taxable at the rate 15% under section 115A. Long-term capital gain, taxable under section 112 at the rate 20%, under section 112A at the rate 10%. And any special income which is covered under section 115A or 115E. On such an income, as I said, the thumb rule will apply that since these are special rate income, basic exemption limit benefit by default would not be available. Now here a very interesting question, my dear friends, for you. Can new slab rate benefit be also availed by a non-resident? So if I go with my general understanding that you have normal rate income taxable in India, on such normal tax rate income, you can avail the benefit of slab rate. Whether the next question, new slab rate can also be availed, my answer to this question is that 115 BAC, which is section in this regard, it does not restrict the benefit of new slab rate to a NRI. Hence, even NRI may avail the benefit of new slab rate if it is being availed in respect of the normal taxable income, not in relation to special rate taxable income of NRI in India. One more question, my dear friends, whether NRI may avail the benefit of rebate under Section 87A, as you all may be aware that as per Section 87A, if NRI has income up to rupees 5 lakh, he may say that ET7A rebate of 12,500 could also be provided to me. There the specific answer is that ET7A benefit is available only to a resident assessee. Hence, in that case, I have to say that NRI can't avail the benefit of ET7A benefit of rupees 12,500 at all. At the end, my dear friends, thank you very much for listening to me. I believe that today's video would have certainly enlightened you in terms of your understanding whether NRI is entitled to avail the basic exemption limit or not. If you have any queries, you can write to me. I'll be highly happy to writing answers to those queries. Thank you very much once again. Jai Hind.